Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. I'm JTP and welcome back to Evolve Stage 2. Today I'm bringing you footage on the Medic, which is one of my favourite classes to play personally. And I'm going to bring you footage on my favourite Medic to play, who is Caira. She's got an amazing gun that does mass damage and mass healing. She can make everyone go super fast and heal everyone in one big boom. So let's get right into the action right now and I'll show you what I mean. Our team today consists of Markov, Jack, Colour and Caira, and of course we are fighting the Kraken. And actually that is amazing skin for the Kraken, the Elder Kraken skin. Never seen that before, but it looks absolutely sexy. So this is going to be an interesting match. Kraken, haven't played against Kraken yet, and he is a monster. So let's see how this match goes, shall we?
Yes, the girl who brings speed.
That is me, and healing, and fire.
Fire and lightning, good combination.
I apologize in advance if I accidentally hit you with a napalm grenade.
Do not apologize, I barely notice.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll just torch you whenever I feel like it.
Do not do that.
Nope, too late, torching you.
Always love the little commentary bits at the start of the round. Nice little humor there, the game adds in there. Okay, here we go. The dropship is here and we are dropping in. Footprints already spotted. And as we know which way the Kraken's gone in, I'm going to activate that speed boost straight away. That's going to allow us to catch up to the monster as fast as possible. Because if we can get the monster before they level up to stage 2, then we've got a huge advantage here. And the speed boost really here, you have to use it strategically. This is why I like playing as the Medic so much. Because as Medic, you can't go out there willy-nilly and just shoot a load of things randomly. You really have to play to your role, and you have to concentrate. There's the Kraken spotted already. You have to concentrate on your role, and we have the Kraken already domed. I'm going to try and get a high spot here and try and get a nice high elevated spot, although it's proving quite difficult. I keep falling off the bloody mountain here. I'm going to napalm it first, and then I'm just going to stay up high and rain health balls down on my teammates. That means they can do all the mass damage. I can't do a lot of damage here, so I'm just going to do my part and heal them as much as possible. Make the Kraken's job as hard as possible. We do not want anyone going down. If the Kraken takes anyone down, our job has, or my job even, has failed. So my primary objective here is to avoid the Kraken's gaze. You can tell this might not be a very experienced hunter, because experienced monsters go for the Medic first, because the Medic is the most annoying member of the hunter squad. So you can see here the Kraken is actually paying no attention to me. The Kraken's going for Danny there. He's going for the mainly support and assault first, because of course they are the main damage dealers. And I'm just weaving in between, getting to high spots, giving my teammates health as much as possible. Everyone's still alive and the Kraken's going to make a move for it. I'm going to napalm it while I can. That'll get some long lasting damage on it and hopefully bring its armor down a little bit more. I've now activated my speed boost, which is going to make everyone a lot faster, and hopefully we can keep up with the Kraken. Kraken really having to fight for his life here. He's still only stage 1. His armor's down. In fact, he's replenished a bit of armor there. Don't know how, and he's getting it out of there as fast as possible. Still within range here. I'm going to fire some napalm over there and hope that I catch him. And I do. I do hit him with one napalm there. That is going to do some damage in the long run. Still shooting here, trying to lay down the waste. If we can get him from afar, then that's just a little bit more extra damage that the team doesn't have to deal. And it doesn't look like he's going to run. The smart thing to do would be to run like fuck right now. The Kraken needs to get out of here, armor up again, and get the hell out. But he has brought us into the indoors. And for the hunters, that's bad. We do not want to fight the monster indoors. That is going to be detrimental to our lives and our health. We want to bring him outside, really. But everyone's still up, thanks to me. Dousing everyone with health again. Haven't used my health boost yet, but I think I'm about to, because the support here is really struggling. There we go. Use my support there, and the dome is down again. The Kraken really not having a good game here. His health is down to almost the last bar, and he's only level 1. No one's gone down yet. The Kraken really needs to concentrate on me, but he's just not doing it. The monster's armor is destroyed one more time, and this looks like the end for the Kraken. He's on his final bit of health. He's domed, and he's going to be domed for a little while longer. And boom, Markov finishing off with the major damage there. Oh my god, what a quick victory. In fact, I don't feel right about uploading this very, very quick round. I'm going to add another round in for you guys. So here we go, no time to waste, straight into the second round, as that round was such a quick victory. I cannot leave you guys on a 5-minute video. Here we go, round two, baby, and this time the hunter is Wraith. And it is the first time this hunter is playing as Wraith, which should work out in our favour, because Wraith is an incredibly hard monster to play, especially when you're first starting out. So it takes a couple of rounds with the Wraith to really get going. I'm assuming this player is new to the game, as you'll see later on in the video. You'll see exactly why I think this player is new to the video. But anyway, using my speed straight away there to try and catch up the monster. We know which direction it went in, thanks to, I think that is Kala's ability to find out which direction the monster's gone in, but there it is, baby. I was about to say we still don't have eyes on it, but of course we have eyes on it. The Wraith has to be so careful at the start. Its health and armor is so low that it can just get wrecked, absolutely wrecked, if it doesn't attack in the stage 2 or above. And this is bad news for the Wraith. We've got it damned. We've got it damned? No, we do not have it damned. Well, it is going to be damned if it doesn't get out of here very soon. But we've got it domed in stage 1. And right now, this Wraith is playing strategically. He's just trying to avoid getting damage as much as possible, moving around, not really engaging, but it's not really working for him. With Markov's mass damage and my napalm grenades, it's incredibly difficult to get out of there. And the Wraith isn't actually attacking the team right now, so I don't feel any means Oh, he's got me! He's got me, but I'm going to get out of there as fast as possible. Whack a health boost on. I'm only down to half health, which isn't too bad. I was about to say that the Wraith isn't actually attacking us, but he did go in for a cheeky attack there. But no, as the Wraith isn't really attacking our team, I don't feel any obligation to start dousing my team with health, so I might as well just do some extra damage to the Wraith here by firing napalm at it. Wraith tries to go for me again, but misses. At least he knows to go for the medic first. It's just not working out for him. It might be very clearly his first time. He's maybe getting used to the Wraith here. And I'm going to whack the speed on once more to try and keep up the Wraith. Now, what I was going to say in the last round, but never got the chance to, was I love playing the medic because you have to really play the medic's role when you're a medic. You can't go out willy-nilly just start shooting things. You have to play very strategically, and you have to play to the role. This means that, oh, I'm going to try and get some napalm there. Does it hit? That's the thing. It's always worth shooting some napalm in the distance if you know which direction it is. Because if it hits, it'll be long-lasting damage. But anyway, especially with Caira, I have to really stay out of the battle a lot. And hang back and just douse my enemy and my teammates with health. I do not want to get involved because the napalm grenades do lingering damage. But they don't do mass damage like Markov, for instance. So I just want to stay out of the battlefield, shooting napalms again like that. Hopefully, we do hit him, I think. Yes, we do. We hit him once. And that's going to do, again, 20 damage every odd second. But now my teammate's taking damage, so I've got to get in there fast. And you'll see here, I'm just going to get to a very high spot. I'm going to then douse my enemies. Not my enemies. My frenemies. With health. If I get in there and I die, then the whole team could go down in a matter of minutes. So my job is to really just stay out of the battle and help my teammates as much as possible. So if you're a guy who likes to go in there and just shoot the place up, which I do like doing every now and then, but I like being the life supporter, you know? Everyone's alive because of me. I have a very important job and I like having that very important job. And here I'm targeting one player at the moment because the Wraith really does seem to be going for this one person. I can't see. I think... is that Trapper? I think that's a Trapper. Maybe trying to take the dome down, but the dome can be initialized by anyone now, so it might not be the Trapper who initialized it. I've actually lost track of the Wraith. That's one thing when fighting the Wraith that's so difficult to me, at least. You lose track of the Wraith so fast because the Wraith is moving so quickly around the map. Like, if someone plays the Wraith well, they can be unseen and get out of there as fast as possible and lose your track within seconds. The Wraith isn't doing much damage to us, and it looks like the Wraith is going to get the hell out of there again. I'm going to use my speed once it comes back. Unfortunately, the speed is still reboosting, so that's going to give the Wraith a couple of seconds to get away, and that's all it really needs. Wraith is such a fast monster that it can get the fuck out of there and hide as fast as your little legs can carry it. But we are on its trail now that I've got my speed, and it looks like it's disappeared. Right now, we're re-relying on the trapper here to find the location of the Wraith, and there we go. It's over in this direction. I just heard it boost over in that direction, so I'm going to spray some napalm just in case it's over there. It's always worth trying. You've got infinite reloads, of course, so why not try? I can hear him eating further over here. There he is, way off in the distance there. Going to try and get some napalm hits, but he's out of there as fast as possible. Oh, sorry, I should say she. Gonna spam that button there. A lot of people say, yeah, you shouldn't spam the button, but hey, why the hell not? A lot of people maybe aren't as coordinated as you, so just spam it so people definitely know where you're going. It's a teamwork thing, right, people? Don't get annoyed. Now, last seen in that direction, but we're right at the edge of the map here, so it's gonna have to go around to our left here. So we're gonna try and go cut it off. Really looking for the high ground here. And the monster has been domed for a third time. Wraith, still not in stage one yet. And this is going to be, well, stage two, sorry. And this is really going to be a problem for Wraith, but this isn't the best place for us to be doming it, especially for me, because there are so many different spots for this Wraith to take cover and hide. I can't get to my whole team for help very quickly, which means the Wraith could take someone out behind one of these pillars here, and I'm not going to be able to get to them in time. So it's quite a tricky battlefield for me to engage and cover, but it does seem to work out. We've got everyone up to full health. The Kraken trying to hide. There it is! I activate my boost out of sheer panic here. I do not want the Wraith to get me. If the Wraith gets me, the whole team could be in jeopardy, so I get the hell out of there using my speed. And the speed might not only be useful for me, might be useful for the other team. If the team are moving very fast, it'll be harder for the Wraith to hit. Everyone getting a bit low on health here, but not enough for me to worry. I'm just going to leisurely get to a nice high spot. The Wraith really is concentrating on the whole team instead of one person. That might be his downfall here. He's going from person to person, but constantly trying to get the Trapper. Maybe he's from the old version of Evolve, where the Trapper could only dome the dinosaur. The dinosaur? The monster. I do not speak England good today. And the Wraith has made another break for it. This guy really has, I wouldn't say a bad strategy, it's a very good strategy getting the hell out of there as soon as possible, but he's now got under 5 minutes to finish this, and he's only stage two. He's only stage one. He's got to get to stage two as fast as possible. If he doesn't get to stage two, especially at the rate he is working, English JGP, especially at the rate he is working, he is not going to be able to take us down in stage one, so we really need to get to stage two. He's going for the attack here again. I'm just going to napalm him. I don't think he's going to be able to do enough damage to my guys. So I'm going to napalm him first, then go in for the heal. And he's made another break for it, the tricky bastard. And you'll see later on, his strategy of coming in for small attacks and then getting hell out of there does come back to bite him in the butt later on, because we do win, but not the way you'd think so. We picked up a buff here, and this is going to be incredibly useful for the Wraith. It's the bullets slow the Wraith down, and because the Wraith is such a fast monster, anything that will slow it down is going to be very beneficial. We'll be able to stay in one spot, and then the damage dealers like Markov can really bring the pain down on this thing. But although it seems we've lost it, problem is with the Wraith, if you know how to, you can dupe the team just like that, and that is exactly what this Wraith has done. We've completely lost track of him. Ah, but the Trapper finds him over in the other side of the map. We were going a completely wrong way. Thank God the Trapper is on hand to do his job. This team is actually working very well. We've got the Trapper and the Medic doing their job, and then the support and assault are really working together to deal the mass damage. And that's what I love about teams on Evolve. Most teams you get on Evolve are very, they know what they're doing, and they're used to the game. A lot of teams on other games like CS, especially when you solo queue, especially on CS, a lot of people just look out for themselves. And that's what I love about this game. Teamwork is the key. You can win very easily if you're working as a team. And if you, especially, I was solo queuing here, and this team was working amazingly. We were communicating over voice chat, we were communicating over text, and even when we weren't communicating over text, we knew what our roles were and we were sticking to it. And that's what I love about this team and Evolve in general. We've got a sight on the monster over here. We can hear it over in the distance. I am marking it like crazy, and everyone's going to change their direction here. We've got to get there as fast as possible, and unfortunately my speed boost isn't available, so we're going to have to make do with our jetpacks. She is just down here. She's done another duke here. She must have passed us a good couple of times, because she's going from one end of the map to the other past us all. But she's only got 2 minutes to finish this. She's going to have to go into stage two immensely quickly. And all this time it's spent for us to find her, she's going to be getting health after armor after health after armor. There we go. Stage two. Thank God. This should be quite an interesting match now. All of that time we spent finding her, she managed to build her evolution meter up, and now she's ready to go into stage two. Our teammates here, little bit fearful. We see a OMG in the chat there, but I'm confident we should be okay. As I said before, this person looks like they're new to the Wraith, so we can take advantage of that and really go at the Wraith's weaknesses that they may not know about. But only 1 minute 15 seconds for them to finish this. Can they do it in time? They're going to have to engage within the next minute, and then they're going to have to stay in combat and finish us. This is going to be an incredibly difficult win for the Wraith. And the Wraith has been spotted. We're going to dome her here. And this is going to have to be the Wraith's final showdown. If the Wraith does not finish this now, the Wraith may not win. She's got 49 seconds. The clock has frozen, but if she does not win this fight, then she's most likely not going to win it. She's trying to get some cover here. Made her... She has like a duplicating ghost kind of ability. I don't know what they call it. She's going to get in there with the supernova, and she's actually going for me quickly, but Markov saving my life there. Oh, maybe not! She grabs me, but doesn't do much damage. I'm going to do the heal burst, and I'm going to get the hell out of there. And this is the Wraith's problem. Well, this is this player's mistake. She's going for more than one person at a time. She really needs to concentrate on me. If she attacks me enough, I will go down fast. The Wraith can do mass damage, especially at stage 2. But in fact, she's going for different people, and that's allowing me to heal different people up as she goes for a new person. If she goes for one person at a time, I'm going to really struggle to keep that person alive. She's trying to keep cover here, and she really needs to do the pain, but maybe she knows that it's just not going to work. That's the fake Wraith. I see the Wraith real one, at least, over there. And she's being sneaky. She's trying to stay out of sight. Maybe she doesn't know that she doesn't have much time left. But she is trying to do the pain. She's on her final 2 bars of health now, though. This is really going to be a difficult win for the Wraith, if possible. And the dome is down. Looks like she's going to get the hell out of there. I'm initiating my speed boost so we can keep up with her. We need to finish this. We now have the means. She's on the run with no armor. If I can just get a few more hits in, if Markov can lay the pain down, we'll be able to get her. Unfortunately, missed those napalm strikes there, but I absolutely love the convenience of Caira's gun. Because you can change from napalm to health regen just like that, and you can do it from a distance. That's what I love about Caira's weaponry. It's absolutely just convenience to the max. And we're hot on the trail here, but the Wraith only has 30 seconds to finish this. She's going to have to turn back, and she's going to have to engage ASAP. Or we're just going to win out of sheer running the clock down. And yes, it's a good idea for us to do this. You know, no, so far, no casualties have been made. Everyone's still at full health. No strikes. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And that is going to be a Hunter win. Maybe
Hunters win.
This was clearly a new player. So maybe the Hunter did not know that she had a time on her, like a time limit to reach, but unfortunately the monster loses and we win our second match of the day. So thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed, please like, share and subscribe, it helps me out a bunch. Caira is my hands down favorite medic of all time. Let me know in the comments down below who you want to see next, and I thank you for all the support on the first episode. It was absolutely amazing. Hopefully you enjoy this one as well. So thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed, please like, share and subscribe, it helps me out a bunch. Until next time, I shall say good bye. Everything is going mental. The medic is still up somehow. The medic is actually being killed by support right now. And she's used her health. She's using her health really well here. The Hunter's coordinated very well. I'm actually Daisy down though, which is brilliant because Daisy is actually the cause of the medic getting back up there. And the medic's now dead. So I don't need to worry about the medic back up now. I'm trying to get Daisy up. It's not going to work. Now going to charge into the... Oh, that's going to get all down to low health. So take out... Is that the support there? And the trapper in a...